Organizations and teams always try and do better, and sometimes implementing tools and resources is one of those great ways to nudge progress forward. Whether that's bringing you all together in one huddle space or mapping out a goal that you have for the future. Today, we're going to dive into some project management applications that I think you'll find beneficial if you are in a team of around five or more, but we're going to give you the best recommendation from our own experience. So before we begin, my name is Francesco. Welcome to Keep Productive. I'm super excited to have you, and we're eager to dive into all of these project management softwares. So do subscribe to us here on Keep Productive, and also check out our newsletters and also our new Tool Finder experience, which will help you go into more depth with all of the applications we've mentioned here in today's feature. So, project management applications are difficult to choose. One of the best bit of advice I have is to not only consolidate information from you and your experience of using project managers, if you're picking them, but bring together knowledge from your team in terms of how they've experienced project management applications. So try to tailor it around best fits of your team versus necessarily what you want to choose. But let's dive into, I think we have 16 that we're gonna recommend in today's video. So the first on our list is a very traditional one. It's owned by Atlassian, which is a very large company which produces high quality software. And Trello is one of those good quality, reliable softwares. And it's one of those softwares, from my experience, that a lot of teams tend to get on with the fastest because of the Kanban layout and its experience. Now, since Trello launched back in the early 2010s, it naturally has evolved, and there are new views to accommodate bigger teams. Now, it's great, I would say, for between teams that are sized about 5 to 100. I think it's really optimized for that. And it comes at a fairly medium price in the market compared to some of the higher end project management tools. Number two is Asana. Now, Asana, again, a really robust, long-standing productivity tool on the market. It was created by the Facebook co-founder, and it has been really one of the best and most reliable productivity tools for projects and for teams for the last couple of years. And Asana presents a really comfortable experience for managing your projects, your tasks, and all other items around it. And what it does do really well is not just design, but it does integrations and workflows very well, helping you to bring together other apps and other parts of the experience that are important. So if you want to connect something that you think is externally valuable for you and your team, Asana likely has an integration for that. And if not, they do have a Zapier integration, which does have plenty of different other options and ways to connect those applications up. Asana, again, is fairly medium priced, maybe a little bit more expensive than Trello, and naturally that changes, but it does present a really good quality experience. If you and your team want some more comforting solutions versus a too flexible option, which some of them might not like. Number three is Active Colab. Now, this is quite popular with marketing agencies and departments, and primarily it looks like many of the others. You can manage your projects, reports, and items, but you can also bring together finances, invoices, and use some of the effective features like commenting, much like Asana and Trello both have too. But it's really a hot hit with marketing departments, and experience, whilst doesn't necessarily have the best design out of all of them, it definitely presents a pretty reliable, outstanding solution in the market when it comes to marketing departments. So number four is Walling. Now, this application was sort of like a personal productivity application, but it's sort of evolved into the project management space over the last couple of years. And it's really much more for the creatives out there. We've got a few tools for creators, those who are working in very maybe design, maybe code, but those departments that require a little bit of creativity involved in it, this one's really good for that. Walling presents a really clean experience, a little bit like Notion in a way, but a little bit like Pinterest too, helping you to bring collective ideas together and still use some of the project management abilities that you'd expect. Maybe not all of them, but definitely some of the ones that I think teams benefit from in a more creative sort of layer. And it does have a much smaller pricing when you compare it to the likes of Asana and Trello, because it's still fairly early days in its project management journey. Number five is TaskAid. Now, TaskAid, again, is great for small to medium-sized teams. One thing I really like about TaskAid is you can flip your view from something very basic like a list all the way over to a mind map. And you can be able to express that information in a wide variety of ways. And it has that layer of asynchronous and remote communication with video calls directly within the conversation and live chat as well, which makes it great for small teams to pop open a video call whilst having the data in front of you there. And it's quite like a little small window into your work, which is really interesting. Now, TaskAid comes at, again, a medium to low pricing and presents a fairly reliable experience, but one that is more, it's more, has more flexible on options, but maybe not the flexibility that we'd see in Asana, ClickUp, Monday, and those sort of larger applications. Number six is Ryke. Ryke's been on the market for some time, and again, a really reliable and robust experience. Much more tailored towards sales and marketing teams. It seems to be a fan favorite with them, but presents a good alternative to applications like Active Colab with a maybe not so amazing interface, but a seemingly reliable set of tools within it. Number seven is Notion. Now, Notion has evolved a lot in the last couple of years. And if you don't know what Notion is, it's basically like a no-code project management tool, but it can be adapted to a lot of experiences. Say you want to use it for your recipe list, you can use it for that. Say you want to use it for meeting notes, it can be used for that, and many different permutations. So Notion can be adapted to a lot of different situations, and that's what a lot of companies like about it. It does have a lot of different ways that you can present information. And one of the things that teams do like about it is the ability to lock views and also create applications for their team. So it does come into a lot of flexible nature. So if your team wants to build something from scratch, this is helpful, but you can also pay consultants and templates to really go deeper with that experience. The one thing I'd say about Notion is sometimes it can be too overwhelming for a lot of people. Learning this sort of thing can take time. And if you and your department want to do that, that's a good investment of your time, especially when you can build what you want for your team. But I haven't come across a company yet above 200 that have used it. I don't know whether that's something that's important, but just something to know when it comes to scalability. Number eight is Monday.com. Now, we all know Monday. It's come up on probably YouTube ads millions of times, but it is a good and reliable way to manage your client projects and also projects in general. I would say it does have a flexible nature to it, maybe not as flexible as something like ClickUp, but presents a really outstanding set of tools that you can map to you and your team. And what's cool is it's got a sort of plug and play nature where you can adapt each of the areas to what best suits you. So if you want a dashboard, you can bring that up. If you want a map, you can bring it up, etc., etc. It's got a lot of functionality to it and structure that a lot of people like in a project management tool. Now, it does have some great templates as well. So if you have that scarcity of being too flexible with the project manager, then this is a good solution to that. And it comes at a medium to high pricing compared to some of the other solutions at its level. So number nine is Catalog. Now, this is a fairly new solution on the market, but I think it's going to be one of the ones that's going to be quite popular in the future. Now, it seems like Catalog are doing something quite interesting with artificial intelligence, helping you to build structures that best suit the way that you and your team work, which is a really interesting step forward in the productivity space. And it seems like they seem to really be investing in the artificial intelligence space, which is a good start. But Catalog presents a way for you to sort of create micro applications inside of your project management experience that suit your needs, but also create an environment that is really tailored around your work. And this is a really interesting step forward in the market. Now, it's hard to compare what this is sort of like, but I would say it's a blend between what you would get in a traditional project management tool like Trello or Asana and something that's more flexible like Notion and Coda. However, Catalog is in its very much its early days. Number 10 is Basecamp. Now, this is developed by the team who created Hey Email, if you watch this channel, and also many other great projects. But Basecamp is one of the most different on our list today. It is really designed for remote and asynchronous scenarios, helping teams to communicate, not necessarily in real time. It's got some great features around events, tasks, managing your own workload and also projects, timeline and dates in the future. And in particular, I love the design and I think the ethos around asynchronous work and the focus towards that is something that will suit you if you're trying to aim towards that market and something I think will be popular in the next couple of years. Now, Basecamp's priced fairly high, but it does have a plan where it is flexible to however many people. So it can be high if you've got a small amount of people, but really low if you've got more people in your team. Number 11 is Coda, and very much like Notion, Coda presents a way that you can build your project management experience. But Coda, I think, goes a step further by introducing improved formula and more recently improved OpenAI features too. And Coda in general presents a more comfortable solution for, I would say, teams that are larger than 150, because what they've had is they've had a lot of sort of market experience. For example, lots of companies at Uber, Google, and many more use Coda within it and obviously take advantage of some of the abilities in there. There's a lot sort of higher amount of people that have large companies who are using Coda versus Notion in the experience that I've seen. Number 12 is ClickUp. And again, ClickUp presents a monday.com-like experience, but offering more flexibility. ClickUp offers a great way to customize your view whilst keeping the traditional structure of a project management application. And what I like about ClickUp is the way that you can customize it and take it that step further. And you can set up automations, workflows, and small things that will save you a large amount of time over the years. And a lot of people like it because it's got a personal and a work view as well, much like monday.com has, but something that a lot of people do like in ClickUp. So next up is Teamwork. Now, Teamwork is a pretty reliable experience. It doesn't look outstanding like many of the others in this list, but it comes into a great comparison between Active, Colab, Rike, and this application. I think those are the sort of three good reliable experience with more traditional structures that doesn't have amazing designs, but it's definitely a really good solution for that. Number 14 is Miele Notes. Now, I mentioned walling earlier, and that was more of a creative solution for teams that are more creativity based. And Miele Note is a great option for that. You can move stuff around the board. It's very free roaming, but you can collaborate on stuff in real time with each other. And a lot of people like that nature of being able to build and plug and play with their experience. So Miele Notes is really nice when it comes to being able to use a more free-form layout of a productivity application. Next up is Smart Suite. And this again is a much more traditional structured project management software. Much like Active Colab, it does present a pretty decent set of tools and a more flexible set of tools that can be used and in a reliable way. So again, not necessarily a design award winner, but something that's gonna give you and your team structure. And I've seen larger teams use it, much larger teams compared to the likes of Notion and Coda collectively. Number 16 is Airtable. Now Airtable, much like Coda and Notion, is a more flexible option, but provides more workflows and more automations in a general sense. You can create real custom workflows and go much deeper with the API inside of Airtable, which suits itself for those teams that want a Notion and Coda level ability of creating a tool, but want to go further with the integrations and collaborations with other applications. And finally, Smartsheet. This one I've seen being sponsoring F1 teams, and I had to check it out a couple of months ago, but it definitely is one of those ones that is more of traditional, much like the ones we've been talking about, like Rike. But you can change your information, and what it tends to do is do well at the dashboardizing your team's workload and also upcoming dates in timeline view and things like that. It's really a nice look for that and presents a good opportunity if you're looking for a much more date-oriented project management experience. So folks, that was all our project management applications. If you are interested and want to subscribe to Keep Productive, you can do. As I said, all of the tools that we mentioned today will be in more depth on Tool Finder. You can find that link in the description below. Thank you so much, folks. Please do make sure to check out more videos here on Keep Productive. There'll be some more recommended after this video, but I think you'll find a lot of value from some of them as we dive into deeper, more in-depth project management and personal productivity tools. All right, folks, thank you very much, and I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio. Thank you very much for watching today's video. If you're interested in checking out some more, you'll find them here. And also you can subscribe too as well. It'd be great to have you here to optimize your tool. And if you're interested in our new email newsletters or our Bento application, or even Tool Finder, which is a new tool that we've created to help you find the perfect productivity tool, you can find it linked in the description.